For most workplace meetings you organize, you'll want attendees to respond to your meeting requests. However, there are times when it doesn't make logical sense to receive them. If organizing a large, open event in which you've invited hundreds of people, it would be impractical to wade through responses. Also, meeting reply emails can take up a lot of valuable space in your inbox and make it difficult to organize messages. Consider that in meeting requests, people have the option to propose new times, and the additional email exchanges simply intensifies the problem. When you create a meeting request, Outlook 2016 provides the option to turn off request responses by removing the checkmark. This automatically turns off the option for attendees to propose new times. However, use caution if you want to turn off responses for work events. Turning responses off disables the tracking command, which allows you to see whether those you invite plan to attend your event or meeting. As an alternative, it's often better to configure a rule to move responses to a dedicated folder or delete them automatically. To create a rule that moves meeting response emails automatically, go to the Home tab, Move Command Group, and select Rules, Manage Rules and Alerts, and New Rule. The Rules Wizard provides several templates and guides you through the rule creation process. You're going to want to start from a blank rule to apply on messages you receive. You can select different conditions. But for this example, I want to select uses the form name form. I want to specify an application form. For example, accept meeting response. I'll add this. You have the option of creating other rules. For example, you could set this up so that all meeting requests are moved to a folder by adding meeting request instead of accept meeting response. What do I want to do with a message? Well, I want to move meeting responses to a specified folder. And that folder, of course, is my meeting responses folder that I just created. There aren't any exceptions in this example, though sometimes there are. For example, if the response comes from a specific person. I could add the exception there. Or if the email includes an attachment. Verify that the rule is turned on. And in my case, I'm going to run this rule on messages already in my inbox. And there they go. Meeting responses are sent automatically to the folder I created. Let's test this on a new meeting. I'll send this to 3 senior management colleagues. Meeting attendance is required. Now I can go to my colleague's inbox. Note that you typically won't have access to your colleague's inbox. They've let me use their inbox only for the purposes of this exercise. I'll accept and send the response. And if I go back to my inbox and my meeting responses folder, and the meeting response emails are delivered automatically to my folder, and they're no longer cluttering up my inbox. Super! When you organize meetings and send meeting requests, you can view the response status of attendees by using the tracking command. To do so, go to your calendar. Open the meeting form you created and select Show Tracking. Select the View Tracking Status drop-down list to display the meeting attendees and their response to your meeting request. This helps you track who will be attending your meeting and who hasn't yet replied. When you're finished using the rule, you can delete it, or you can easily disable this rule by going to File, Info, and selecting Manage Rules and Alerts. Simply uncheck the checkbox next to the rule. Note that this disables the rule, it doesn't delete it, so you can activate it and use it again in the future if you want. Of course, you can also activate or deactivate rules by going to Home, Rules, Manage and Create Rules. You've learned how to manage meeting responses by configuring a rule to move responses to a dedicated folder. You've also learned how to view the tracking status of attendees.